Welcome to Cafe Noma and welcome to our reaction to Roy Orbison. And we are going to react to the song Penny Arcade.
So first time single take honest reaction by both of us. Let's get started by listening to this request. Child, not exactly a penny arcade.
Yeah,
this must have been back in the 60s, maybe 50s. Who knows? What are your thoughts?
And we had only the fair, we didn't have none of this
in the village. Yeah,
no, here too in Mumbai, I never entered that gaming parlor thing. I think it was thing of a boy of the boys.
Yeah, and here it was very addictive, it was an addiction. You needed counseling or therapy.
You did.
Serious therapy to get out of it. Because people would, the kids would start robbing things from home and all to get money.
Just to get there, yeah.
To sell, you know, and get money for those coins. Those coins actually add up to a lot.
They do.
And many of those gaming arcades and parlors must have made millions of rupees back in the day.
And the worst part was not the parlor guy being a pervert kind of a character. They would be the most nice people who would be very inviting to the boys. I think they would be encouraging enough to come and play there. So they wouldn't, you know, cross their line with the children. They would never touch them. But they would be very inviting. They would, yeah, make sure that the children keep coming because they were making a lot of money. So here the problem was not the guy taking advantage of the children, but it was, he was too good for them to keep on coming.
This had a lot of innocence though. This song had a lot of innocence. It was pure, it was simple. It talks about the colorful nature of all those machines, those games.
He also had to grab the coins.
Very yeah, it's easy. Very tempting. It's all exciting. You don't know where to stop, what to play. But the money, unfortunately, it gets over very quickly. Sometimes you win. In the gaming palaces that I'm talking about back in South Mumbai, and even in the suburbs, later on when I moved to the suburbs, there you would win money sometimes. So they would make, and that sound would be the best sound
that
you know you could hear as a kid. If you went to those gaming parlors and you won the money, that slot machine sound falls into these little plastic buckets. Oh, everyone in the gaming parlor would turn when they heard that sound to see who has won something. But unfortunately, that sound would not come more than twice in a day, maybe. I've not been there much, to be honest, but whenever I have been, and even when I went with friends, because some of them had a lot of money and they were addicted to it, you know, you wouldn't hear that sound more than twice in 5, 6, 7 hours, maybe.
Kudos to Roy, obviously, in the way this is
time
screen.
Would go by very quickly in these kind of penny arcades and gaming parlors.
The reality of the matter is your fun lasts only as long as your money lasts.
Yeah, then you have to see what others are doing. You know, be a. It's just like a casino, you know. I mean, it's a childhood casino.
Yeah, childhood casino.
It's like a casino for kids.
They would have dark colored doors. I remember they would have black colored doors.
But at least the ones I'm talking about here, because you win money too. There, I don't think you get money. So either ways, whatever was happening here was quite wrong, because getting kids into it at such a tender age.
They would have to show them that you get something in.
We didn't know, and neither did our parents know that we ever went there, I think. Unless it became a severe problem and they needed serious help.
Actually, parents, there were points and there were children who were stalked by their parents and, you know, they would find out.
Yeah, because things used to disappear from home.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, because
I had a friend of mine who was addicted and his family and all of us got to know because we all started following this person.
Yeah, and you know, talking about that, I don't want to talk about it because the song is not about all that.
Yeah.
But they should share a bit of our childhood and bit of how life was here. There was actually a guy who sold a music system. You know, he sold an entire music system to get these coins to play at the gaming arcade. So that is how it can be. And that guy wasn't me. But yeah, I love my music system. I love every music system that we own. I would never, never, ever get rid of it unless it was broken and couldn't be repaired.
This lasted till the mobile smartphones came in every hand. After that, this parlor thing went off because it was the biggest evil of, I think, entire Mumbai city for all young children, and every parent wanted to save their child from that black door gaming parlor scene. When I was growing up.
Many kids, even in the US, I'm assuming this is primarily a song for American, made about American kids. So, in the US also, it must have been quite an addiction. You know, I mean, it must have been enjoyable, but beyond a point
it becomes a social evil. That's what it turns
into an addiction.
Then,
even if you don't, if you're not gambling the money, you're literally losing the money.
You're spending a lot of time as well.
And yeah, you're getting entertained. It's like watching a movie, you would say. But at that age, you know, to get into all that. Yeah, I mean, it's a perspective of a parent. It's obviously, I wouldn't want my kids to be part of such a thing, you know. I mean, because
it also affected the school performance and presence in other areas of those children completely. They would always be centered. Their mind would always be attached to that place that I have to go there. They would only think about when they're going to go there.
Yeah, but on a happier note, this song was fun to listen to. It was happy. It was pure. It had a lot of innocence.
Yeah.
It's as if a kid was singing, although it's an adult's voice, and he must have been an adult when he sang it. It's beautiful, beautiful to listen to, short and sweet, unlike our review and discussion.
Let's keep it that way.
Yeah, but it's important to share a bit of our analysis, otherwise how is it an Indian couple reacting to music from the West mainly? How would it be our Indian reaction if we don't share bits and pieces of our own lives, off and on?
Thank you for your time.